Vaquitas are unique for a couple of reasons. One, most porpoises are cold water species, but the vaquita are a warm water species, a tropical species. But really it is their very small range. Typically, when we look at the distribution of different porpoise species, they can be fairly large. In fact, for the Dall's porpoise, it's the realm of the entire North Pacific Ocean from Japan to California. But that's not the case with Vaquita. Vaquita are found in a very, very small region within the Sea of Cortez, the upper Gulf of California. And in fact, I believe it accounts for less than 1% of the entire surface area of our planet's oceans. The thing with gillnets is they really don't have much of an opportunity for the animals to survive once they're in. They're designed to catch fish. Gillnets are a very successful fishing gear that are used around the world with different mesh sizes that go according to the different species that are desired. Unfortunately, they can be indiscriminate and non-selective and can catch more than the desired species of the fishery. And unfortunately, because of the nature of gillnets, there really is no escape route once the animals are caught, and they will simply die. It was a tremendous privilege to join the expedition in 2008, and our mission on that particular scientific expedition was to find the vaquita and to get an accurate population estimate, to find out, you know, how many animals are there. And it really was quite tremendous and an honor to see them in the wild. And there's one day that always stands out in my mind, where in one afternoon we saw half of the entire world's population of vaquita. And that's both tremendously exciting and terribly disappointing at the same time, that there would be so few left. Looking back, I wish now, if only we could have that many vaquita at this point in time, because most of the animals that I saw have died. And that's a tremendously sad state, knowing that had they have not encountered fishing nets, they could very well still be alive. It would be within their known lifespan. The efforts that Mexico has taken and the scientific community has taken, and so many organizations, particularly in the US but around the world, have taken to try to prevent us from getting to where we are today, is tremendous. It's extraordinary, and I can't thank people enough, because had those efforts not have been taken, we may not have vaquita at this point in time. But the reality is we've only got, we think, about 25 animals left. And if we don't save those animals, the vaquita species will go extinct. 25 individual vaquita are left. So the upcoming expedition is not to try and census the population. It is to try and find the last few vaquita and save them by relocating them to a safe habitat. And personally, I want my son to grow up in a world that has vaquita and the diversity of animals that we have on the planet today.